What's up, Wagwan? Etta Say, it's Lexa C. Welcome back to my channel if you're not new, and if you're new here, welcome. Today you are going to see me basically go from my bare face to this plus this hair. I thought I'd just film a quick get ready with me of how I get myself ready to film content. I like to have quite a neutral makeup look when I'm filming content, so yeah. Watch if you're interested. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and yeah, enjoy the video. So this is obviously going to be a voiceover. I'm just showing you guys what I typically do. So to start with, I already had my wig laid on, so I am just quickly straightening my hair. As you can see, I'm not straightening it properly, but as I get into the look, you'll understand why. It's because my hair isn't actually going to be straight, so it didn't need to be bone straight, dead straight, as though I was going for a straight hair look. If I was going for straight hair, I would be taking way more time and I'd be straightening track by track. But yeah, we're not doing that. So I'm just using the Remington wide plates and straightening and just finger combing the hair before then going in with a little comb to make sure that the hair's not tangled. Oh, by the way, this wig is from West Kiss Hair. Really forgot to mention that, so I'm mentioning it now. It's a ready-made wig from West Kiss Hair. Once I'm done straightening, I am just gonna quickly start to section off the hair, starting with the front because I need to know what the waves are gonna look like. So I'm just combing and taking a little section and I am going to curl it. I typically only actually add waves to the ends because I don't want the whole head curly, but yeah, so I'm starting by adding some waves to the ends. This wand, or curling barrel as you might call it, is also from Remington. It's my sister's, we've had it for ages, so yeah, but I love it, it just does the job. So if you make sure you hold for quite a substantial amount of time, you'll usually get the waves that you're after. So once I let this go, I should have a nice bouncy loose wave to the bottom half of the hair. After which, I'm just gonna let you guys watch me do a few at the front so you get the gist of what I'm doing. I do not brush out these waves. So usually when I am getting ready to film content, I like to come on Instagram live so that you guys can keep me company while I get ready. But that's totally dependent on what time of day it is. If I'm getting ready quite late, for example, then I like to talk on the phone. I just think it helps the time pass faster and just makes me feel a bit more like I'm doing more than one thing at once. I'm usually not obviously filming myself getting ready, so it's not usually that big of a nuisance, but yeah, I like to chat on the phone to help the time go by. So now we've just moved on to the other side and we're about to finish off. I think what the waves at the front look like is super important because, like I said, it's only the bottom ends, but you want to make sure that, you know, they're coming off how you want them to. As you can see, I actually do my waves inwards. That's because I don't want them pulling out. The way in which you decide to wrap your barrel when you are curling will make a difference to how your curls or your waves look. So yeah, this is what I do. Obviously, if you wanted them to frame your face differently, then you'd probably go the other way. One thing about me, I'm gonna do it again if it doesn't look how I want it to. So that's what I'm just doing here. I'm making sure that the waves are a lot more defined. So once done, I just pin it to make sure that the hair is out of my face so that I can start my makeup. I really do not like doing my makeup if there's going to be hair in my face. And let's just take a good drink of water from my Cass Fitness water bottle. Woo! Anywho, if you know me, you know I start my makeup with my brows. So I am just filling in my brows. I do still carve them out, but that's really because I don't have much eyebrow. So I don't know about you lot who don't conceal your brows, but I need to. I need to conceal my brows to give myself a shape. I have an arch in my brows, but like, yeah, there's not much going on because the ends are so sparse. So yeah, we're gonna do my brows and then move on. So I actually prime my face after doing my eyebrows rather than before, just because my primer makes applying my brows really slippery and I don't like that. So I'm just priming my face with my Maybelline Baby Skin Pore Eraser, that primer, the one that I always use. And yeah, really making sure that I cover every part of my face because my skin is really dry. And when I do not prime, it does not work well. So for foundation, I'm going in with my NARS Radiant Longwear Foundation in the shade Caracas. I haven't moved on to NARS Soft Matte. I just have really dry skin and I do not know if it will work for me. So this is the shade I use on all of my face bar my forehead, and I use the shade Macao on my forehead. I just dot it around with my ring finger and then I start to blend with a brush. I always use a brush for my foundation and actually for my concealer as well. So now that we're done blending foundation, I'm just showing you how I do my concealer now. This is the only thing I would say in my makeup routine that has actually changed, just because I saw a bunch of beauty babes saying that this was better to make sure that you weren't dragging your concealer too far down. I didn't used to drag my concealer far down, I don't believe, but yeah, I've been doing this recently and I like how it looks at the end. So this is the new way I apply my concealer. Nothing in the middle, just either corner of each eye. The concealer that I'm using is my Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer in the shade Mocha. So I actually use two concealers, but I make sure that I finished blending the first one out before I add the second, and like I said, I blend with a brush. The second concealer I use, just to highlight that a bit more, is called Le Concealer de Chanel and it is in the shade 20 beige. It gives the under eye that pop that I need because, to be very honest, Mocha is very close to my skin tone. So when I use the Chanel concealer, I tend to need to use a Real Techniques sponge just to make sure that that's completely blended out, just because it's a much lighter shade. So that is what I'm doing real quick now. And then we are going to set the under eye. So we're just setting with the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder in Honey. That is pretty much the only powder that I use under my eyes. And if it's not that, then I use the Huda Beauty Easy Bake Powder in the shade Blondie. Now onto contour. I'm using my flat contour brush to do my cheeks. I am using my Revolution Splendor Glow Ultra. I never know how to say this properly. So many words. Anyway, I'm using it in the shade medium. You know the one. And that's what I use to contour, just to bring the dimensions back into my face. So I use that on my cheekbones and then the edges of my forehead. Like it, like it, like it, Once I have finished applying that contour with that particular brush, I then blend it with another brush, because this Real Techniques brush is just a lot fluffier, and I think it helps to make the line of demarcation a lot less harsh. I then contour my nose with the exact same bronzer, and I use the same brush. It's really quite like narrow in a good way, so yeah. So now we're on to blush, and I'm using my favourite, which is the Rimmel London Maxi Blush, a powder in the shade 3 Wildcard. I love this blush. I just think it's really, really pretty, and it always does the job, especially when I'm going for quite a nice, natural, neutral look. So before doing my eyes, I just go over my face with my face powder, which is the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in the shade Dark Tan, and that is what I set my face with. Actually, for this particular look, when I'm shooting content, I like to use that same powder as my eyeshadow. Reason for that is I don't actually want that much pigment on my eyes. So if I don't want my eyelids to look a different color, then I just use my face powder. If I did want them to look a bit darker, sometimes I will use my bronzer, but I only really get out my eyeshadow palettes when I'm actually going for looks, which I don't tend to do when I'm filming content. So oftentimes I like to add some eyeliner when I am doing this plain look, just because there's nothing on my eyelids, like I said. So I'm just giving you a cute little wing to, again, lift those eyes. I really like my eye shape, like I really enjoy my eye shape, and I used to wear eyeliner every day. Like, there was a point in secondary school when I literally wore eyeliner every day. I just love it. Oh, also the eyeliner I'm using is the Too Faced Better Than Sex Easy Glide Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner in Deepest Black. So now I'm just setting my face with my Lottie London Dewy Finish Setting Spray. Gotta set that face, hun. Because my skin's so dry, once again, when I do not set my face, it does not bang. We are wearing my lashes from Touched by Tana. I love these lashes. They are so gorgeous. There's a lash star for everyone on Touched by Tana, so yeah. And I always use a mascara for my bottom lashes. My bottom lashes are cute and I want them to show, so yeah, I just bring them back. What I like about this particular makeup look is, because there's not much going on generally, I feel like my eyes look nice and intense, which I think is beautiful. And now for my favorite bit, lips. So just wiping my lip balm off so I can get started. I start by lining my lips with a dark brown pencil. In this case, I'm actually using my Rimmel London brow pencil, but usually I use a Bourjois Paris pencil in Grwm Design, the shade 07. After which I will go in with Cork by MAC. So when it comes to lining my lips, I'm always keen to preserve my shape, because I actually love my lip shape so much. So I don't overline my lips because I don't see the need for me personally, but I get why people do, because duh, you want the shape you want. When it comes to glosses, I have loads. So I'm using 2 Kiko glosses, 1 Pat McGrath gloss and 1 Revolution gloss. I have a reel out on my Instagram where you can pretty much see every gloss that I have, but I will do a cute gloss haul soon. Every time I put a gloss on, I'm like, is this what I want? No, let's add to that. And that is what I do until I find the exact shade that I'm after for that look. We want like a nudie peachy pink. So we were almost there just here, but we weren't quite there. This was just a tad boring. So Pat McGrath came to give the girls what needed to be gave. And just look at that. Just look at that. Delicious. Okay, and that is it. So this is typically what I would do to get my hair and my face content ready, so to speak. And yeah, we're good to go. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you mess with it, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.